Hi there guys, this is Nikhil from GreedyTech and this is a comparison between Oneplus 3 and the ZUK Z1. Yes, I know it's a crazy comparison and we are comparing two phones from two different price segments. You can literally buy two Z1s for the price of one Oneplus 3. It's more justifiable to compare the Oneplus 1 with the ZUK Z1, but this is a video on demand. Oneplus 3 is better than the Z1, but where does it stand when you compare both the phones? Come, let's find out. All the phones released in the past 6 months had pretty good design and build quality. Oneplus 3 comes with a unibody metal design with a 2.5D curved glass on the top, an alert slider on the left, a protruded camera bump on the back and a fingerprint scanner on the front with ceramic coating. Z1 comes with a normal metal frame with curved plastic back panel and a fingerprint scanner on the front which looks like some cheap plastic button. Oneplus 3 definitely looks more premium and feels lighter than Z1, but Z1 isn't all that bad either. If I give a 9 for Oneplus 3, I would give somewhere around 6 or 7 for Z1 in terms of build and design. Both the phones have very similar hardware, both come with LED notification, OTG support, USB Type-C charging port, all the basic sensors including the gyroscope. We can save 5 fingerprints on both the devices and the fingerprint scanner performs very quickly on Oneplus 3. On Z1, it's decently fast. Both unlock the phone in less than a second, so you will not notice any difference in the speed. As of now, we can unlock applications on Oneplus 3 using the fingerprint scanner, but we can't on the Z1. When it gets an official update to CM13, we can do that too. We can unlock apps on Z1 too. We don't have any complaints with the button placement of both the devices. On Oneplus 3, we get an alert slider on the left side to easily switch between the interrupt modes. Though it was inspired from Apple, it definitely comes in very handy, and you will be using it more frequently without even realizing it. It's specifically handy when you want to put your phone to sleep without actually waking it. Additionally, Oneplus 3 has NFC, which most of you will never use, at least in India. Oneplus 3 comes with 5.5-inch Full HD Optic AMOLED display and the Z1 comes with a normal 5.5-inch Full HD IPS display with 100% color gamut color reproduction. Both the displays are pretty good and for all the geeks, yes, Oneplus 3 has the better display. But most of you won't notice the difference easily, especially in the daylight. Both the phones come with screen gestures like double tap to wake and options to change display color temperature. Screen gestures are not very accurate on the Z1 and that you will notice. This is where you'll see a huge difference. Oneplus 3 justifies its price by providing amazing cameras. Most of the time, you will get perfect shots only on one click. You will never have to check them to see if they came out right. At least I never checked. Camera on Z1 is pretty good for the price, but definitely not as good as Oneplus 3. Shots on Z1 won't be as perfect as Oneplus 3, so you might have to take your time to get those perfect shots. And currently, the camera app on the Z1 is inconsistent. Sometimes autofocus works, sometimes it doesn't. If you're not a photographer or too picky about the camera, then you can live with the Z1's camera. Oneplus 3 comes with a 2016 flagship processor from Qualcomm, Snapdragon 820 with Adreno 530 GPU, 6GB of RAM and 64GB of internal storage. ZUK comes with a 2014 flagship processor, Snapdragon 801 with Adreno 330 GPU, 3GB of RAM and 64GB of internal storage. These are the benchmark scores. We were prepared to see these kind of results. Oneplus 3 simply rocks because of the better processor. Gaming performance will be very similar as well. You can play any game at best visuals with less heating issues on the Oneplus 3 and with noticeable heating issues on the Z1. On Z1, you can't download some games from Play Store due to the compatibility issues, but you can download the APK file from the web and try it. Most of the games work, only few don't. Performance in day-to-day activities like opening apps, switching between them will be very similar in both the devices. Oneplus 3 will be faster by few milliseconds or few seconds in some situations like opening huge games like Asphalt 8. I won't say Z1 is slower, but Oneplus 3 definitely feels very faster. And that you can notice only if you compare them side by side. Oneplus 3 comes with 6GB of RAM, so it keeps a lot of apps in the memory and probably none of the apps you use frequently will be restarted. All the apps are in the memory, just a touch away. Z1 has pretty good RAM management with 3GB of RAM, which I think it's more than enough for today's standards. If you use 5 to 10 apps regularly, you get the same effect as in Oneplus 3. OnePlus 3 runs on Oxygen OS, a slightly customized version of stock Android Marshmallow, comes with some software features like ambient display, proximity wake, dark mode, screen gestures, and shelf. Z1 comes with CyanogenOS 12.1 out of the box. It has all the features of OnePlus 3 with some additional features. Z1 offers a lot of customization and control over the app permissions. Additionally, we have the Cyanogen themes, which changes the look and feel of all the apps. This is the biggest selling point for the ZUK Z1. In terms of software experience, both are good, both are very fluid. OnePlus 3 will be slightly faster only when you compare them side by side, but you will like the Z1's software experience if you like the concept of changing the themes. Rooting both the phones will not void warranty, and there are a lot of custom ROMs for both the devices. Additionally, OnePlus has already released the kernel source code of OnePlus 3, so you can expect a lot of stable custom ROMs for OnePlus 3. When it comes to audio, there isn't any fancy names or any sound enhancement for both their phones. But I personally felt audio experience on OnePlus 3 was better than the Z1 via the headset, and the OnePlus 3 also felt louder than Z1 with the mono speaker. There's a huge difference in the battery department. Though both the devices come with a USB Type-C port, OnePlus 3 comes with a smaller 3000mAh battery with dash charger that can charge the OnePlus 3 completely in 1 hour. Z1 comes with a bigger 4100mAh battery with a normal fast charger that charges the Z1 in 2.5 hours. I would say it's pretty much a tie in the battery department. With OnePlus 3 you can survive a day and you can charge it very quickly. With Z1 you might be able to survive 2 days on a single charge on normal usage, but it'll take about 2.5 hours to fully charge the phone. OnePlus 3 also comes with some additional perks like free OnePlus Care for a year, Amazon Kindle ebook gift voucher, and some other stuff in India. OnePlus 3 is definitely better than Z1, but you will notice a significant difference only in the camera department. If you're a normal user who isn't very picky about the camera performance and want to save some money, you can definitely buy the Z1. And if you're someone who wants the best of everything at a very reasonable price, then you can buy the OnePlus 3. But do remember, there's no point in paying for something that you don't use. And coming to my preference, I would definitely buy the OnePlus 3 because of its performance, but if I'm short on the cash, I'll definitely buy the Z1 instead. So what about you? What do you think? Do let me know by commenting below this video. If you like this video, hit that like button and stay tuned to us by subscribing to our channel. I'll catch up with you in my next video. Until then, have a nice day.